It's a week out from the general election, and in a moment we'll hear from AUT lecturer and political commentator Richard Pamatata with his thoughts on the election. But first, John Pulu is at the Mangere Markets with some of our Pasifika candidates. Talofa, John.
As I mentioned, we've moved away from the markets and we're here in the heart, which is the Mangere Town Centre. And right now I have two guests. First, we have Le Maunga here to the left from the Labour Party, as well as Rosemary Burke from the National Party. I swear the supporters have just grown over the last few seconds. But first of all, Le Maunga, good morning to you.
Talofa, and good morning to you, JP.
How are things going?
Good, great.
Tell me about you are going to replace or represent Mangere. It's a big shoe to fill following Aupito Williams-Seal.
Huge shoes to fill. Very privileged to be the Labour candidate 2023 with Aupito moving out. So I've got a history of working in this community and I'm very privileged to be in this role.
Now, Labour has to do a lot according to the polls. What will you do to regain some of that momentum?
So, John, we just need to keep doing the things that we're doing, knock on the doors, talk to our community, see what the issues are. Labour government has a strong record, and we want to continue the work here in Mangere.
So tell us about some of the... What are you hearing from the people here in Mangere? What are they asking for?
So our young people are talking about things like cost of living, working and going to school. Our families are also talking about cost of living, but what the government has delivered for the people of Mangere: housing, transport issues, and also jobs and the pay parity, and the issues that we've been doing in the government since 2017.
Now, the cost of living is a biggie this time round. Do you think the Labour government, you guys have been in power for a while, do you think you've done enough?
We can always do more, John. And so that's the plan, is when we get back in government, it is to do more for our community. My role would be to strongly advocate for Mangere, for South Auckland.
20 seconds, if you could just look down the barrel and speak to those who are still yet to vote.
Families, community, people, get out to vote. Whoever you're going to vote for, Labour has a strong record. You need to use your voice. So make your decision, get to the polling booth and vote while you can. Kia kaha.
All the best, Le Maunga. All right, as I mentioned earlier, we've got Rosemary Burke here representing Mangere for the National Party. Talofa.
Malulay, John.
How are things going with you? It looks like National, in terms of the polls, it's looking good.
Well, we don't take anything for granted. Working hard, and we're still going to work out up to the date.
Yeah, tell me about what's your week been like out campaigning.
Oh, it's everywhere. No, you've got to be out there with the people in your community. No, and letting them talk to you and listening to them, yeah.
You're in a very tough seat here. It's very red here. So what's your goal, you know, with your candidacy this time?
Look, I've known it always to be red, but Mangere doesn't belong to parties. It's about the people. So it's really important that people understand that they have a voice and they can vote and make a difference.
So what does National offer that the government's not offering at the moment? What are you bringing to the table?
But we want to rebuild the economy and lift the businesses so incomes and people in our community can have those incomes that they don't have at the moment. You know, cut taxes, you know. I just think of the cost of living and people talk about that all the time. And that's not just here in Mangere, it's all over New Zealand.
Now, advanced voting has kicked off already this week. What's your message for those who are yet to vote?
Look, just get out and vote. Some people are waiting for this card that they haven't got. You don't need it. You can go and vote. And it's important. It's your voice.
And you'll be out here as well as your other colleagues campaigning this morning at the markets?
We'll be out here, out anywhere our people are. So it's important that we're seen and present.
Thank you.
All right, that's us here at the Mangere Town Centre. We'll be back very soon with two more candidates. Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, John. We'll hear from you in a moment. Well, Richard joining us now. We see a lot of the fanfare out there this morning with the National and Labour supporters. And Rosemary said then that the Mangere seat doesn't belong to one party. Lydia, of course, she's got a bit of history with the local people, but taking over from Seal, do you think it'll be easy for her?
She does have to be consistent with what she's doing and she's working hard. I would disagree with the National candidate. I think that the South Auckland seat of Mangere is very firmly entrenched with Labour in the same way that the North Shore is a national seat. So these things don't change overnight.
We have seen the shift, though, in the polls towards national. Do you think with our community there is a shift with some voters wanting to also go towards national as well?
And we should expect that. People don't need to necessarily vote for a particular party because their parents did. But the national candidate talked about taxes, didn't she? And the benefits for voting that. Well, what we've seen lately is that the National Party offering is hollow and they have not actually done the numbers. So I think anybody who's voting needs to look at the arithmetic that sits behind everybody's offering. Labor needed to work harder, which is why the polls are the way they are. And the other thing people need to hold on to is at the polls, you have the same power as everybody else. You are equal.
And that's a good point you made earlier about the National Party, and a lot of our community won't benefit from those tax cuts. There's a lot of the focus towards the squeeze middle, but not so much for our Pacific people. We'll be missing out there. And in terms of Labor and what they've done the last 6 years, you think that have they done enough?
Well, they've done what they had to do. We had a pandemic. 20,000 people didn't die because of the vaccination program. Could they have done more? Of course they could have done more, but then every political party faces those things. What we have seen, though, is people being uncomfortable and looking for more as the cost of living pressures come on them. So naturally, they're going to look somewhere else. Whether or not that's the right place, I don't know.
And we'll talk more about this as well later on in the program. Thank you, Richard.